Well, it's a significant concern. Nuclear proliferation, the countries gaining access to nuclear weapons, especially countries that are hostile or in leaders that are capricious. It's a real concern, and it is already a nuclear state. We're talking about a country that has a significant number of nuclear weapons. They're hiding them well to try to make sure that there can be no preemptive strike by the West. But the president's strategy is absolutely all over the map, and you have to have a coherent, determined strategy if you're going to take this on. The challenge is that there are three ways to get rid of the nuclear weapon program. One is with military action, one is with Chinese pressure, and the third is with dialogue or negotiations. And none of them do we have the kind of a perfect instrument. Let's remember that Seoul is within reach of artillery from the North Koreans. They have a vast array of artillery aimed at Seoul. If we, in a preemptive strike on North Korea, first of all, we can't take out all their nuclear weapons because they've hidden them. Second of all, they can destroy Seoul immediately. And you're talking 10,000 people who would die of one of our allies immediately. So there's you have to be a little careful about ultimatums and assuming that there is a risk-free strategy. Right now, the administration's message is one day it's about military pressure, the next day it's about Chinese pressure, the next day it's about negotiation. They've talked about all three. You've got to have a coherent, determined strategy, and China is going to be essential to this. And so, I mean, the president's team has recognized that's important, but they keep changing their location. If you have a situation where you have a massive space for miscommunication, which is what we have right now, because the North Koreans don't really know what strategy we're pursuing and what to expect, you have the opportunity for events to quickly spiral out of control.